Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey.
How you doing?
Good.
That's the soup and taco. You good?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Well, I certainly want to thank the organizers, John, I guess, my father, Open City, Chad also, and of course Travis, our guys, Rob House, Mark Bruno. I see some friendly faces here, Coaster Kids, I hear them as well, but it's good to see you guys. You know, I take these opportunities to learn a little. Okay. Now, I'm sure there's an elephant in the room. Want to read the elephant in the room? What's your next coaster? Okay. We'll talk about that later. Let's get rid of that elephant. I also understand we're going to do some last rides today. Do you know the rides that you're riding? Have that been announced yet?
Not yet.
Okay. Well, it's going to be Lightning Run for sure. Cyclos, but what's really interesting is we're going to have the last ride, the Enterprise. The Enterprise is a ride I bought in 1990 at the original park. It's a bus ride. And we're retiring the Enterprise, and you all will be on the last ride of the Enterprise.
Exciting and sad.
Every ride has its own life cycle. That ride is almost 25 years old now in terms of being in operation. And we get a little concerned when we hit that point where the ride gets to be that age. Also, it's very, very difficult to replace the parts. They don't make the hydraulic motors anymore. So we're going to put that in Northport. It's been a great run for the Enterprise, and we'll have the last ride. Let me ask you guys a question. You know, I noticed that the beach, I had occasionally reviewed the top 50 wind coasters, top 50 steel coasters in this year's Golden Globe Award. And it's interesting. By my count, and I wrote it down this morning, I want to share it with you, it's interesting. So Cedar Point had four steel coasters. I'm only talking about the steel coasters. Cedar Point had four steel coasters in the top 50. Magic Mountain, understandably, had three coasters in the top 50. You know, young man, you want to come up here, thank you. I can't hear myself. Thank you. Appreciate that. So again, Cedar Point had four in the top 50. Magic Mountain had three in the top 50. Busch Gardens, Tampa had three. Busch Gardens, Williamsburg had three. That's it. Only four parks in the world had more steel coasters in the top 50 than Kentucky Twinkle. And we're really proud of that. Now here's a question for you. What makes that really ironic? Anybody know the answer to that? Why is that an odd fact? Yes, sir. That's a good answer, but no, that's not that. We do have a height restriction. It's about 220 feet. That's why we're saving this land over here. What makes that odd? I don't know if you're all familiar with my background. I don't ride the rides ever. I have motion sickness. But who selects the rides? I do. So somehow we managed to select rides that wound up in the top 50 in the world from a guy who never rides rides. Okay? I do that with a little help from our tech service guys, Bill Hargrave and company. They help me with the selection of rides. We're very proud of that. But here's my question to you all. You can help me with this. In 1990, Thunder Run was ranked the number one wind coaster in the world. In 1990, first put it in. Charlie Dinn's last roller coaster that he designed. You know, Charlie's the Beast. You guys know more about this than I do. And I noticed the Beast is still in the top six. I think it's ranked six in the wind coaster. But Thunder Run is not on the list. Is there a reason for that? We've spent $2 million over the last 4 years reprofiling the track, getting a new train. Is there something about Thunder Run I should know about that is not considered one of the top 50 wooden coasters? Please, don't be shy. Help me out.
It's amazing. Don't change it.
Okay, I got an amazing from Travis. At the moment, why is it not considered? Yes, young man, there it is. Go ahead. Say what?
I did 4 minutes.
Well, why not?
It's too rough.
Okay. Any particular part of the ride that's rough or overall?
Overall.
Okay. Have you ridden Holly Rolls or Wood Coaster? Before we talk about that, I want to hear all the
I don't want to know.
You know, there's a crazy thought, and I'm being very frank about this. There's a crazy thought that coaster enthusiasts really like wooden coasters. Yeah, say, look at this.
No. Chris is like,
you yeah. really like to be shaped, rattled, and rattled with wooden coasters. The problem is, most guests don't like that experience. So maybe we've actually, we got it rough here. We think we're making it smoother, not rougher. So I guess that can make the world tick. Different points of view. When we spent $2 million on that coaster, we continue to spend money every year to try to keep it as smooth as possible, given the rule of all. Yeah.
Is that better?
Yeah. Yeah.
Looks like. I agree. I just think it's underappreciated, but maybe that's from a proud pop. Any questions you'll have on anything? I certainly appreciate your patronage. We'd love to see you all every single year. I know you stop by at different times during the year. I think we have some season pass holders here as well. We really appreciate your business. Very nice. So just let me open up any questions you may have. I'm certainly happy to field them. And if not, just enjoy your... You got one on you? Yeah. What do you got?
Hi.
Oh, good. Okay.
Hello.
Hello.
David from Cincinnati.
The volcano.
Yes.
Woo!
It's a good ride.
Thunder Run is not too bad. It's definitely much better than it was before you refurbished it. It's wonderful. I think the reason is that there's just a lot of people who want to go to the parks just don't get enough voters to come down here and see how good it is.
Okay, that makes a lot of sense. That means you all have to do a better job at getting people to come to Kentucky Canyon.
I'm trying.
To enjoy Thunder Run.
And what you need to do is on the hill lift at Thunderbird at Holiday World, you need to put a big sign up on the road with our logo on with Kentucky Canyon.
Don't you love those spicy Kingdom folk?
She is not affiliated with my podcast.
Thank you for those comments about Thunder Run. On that subject, about some of the bigger parks, I mean, listen, Holiday World's a great facility. Kings Island is a pretty good facility. We're just fortunate to be part of the Midwestern theme park entourage, if you would. On that front, you know, in 2014 we opened up. We did a good attendance number. We only advertised in the legal market. In 2015, we extended our advertising to the outer markets. And we matched business. In 2016, we were up 41% on each show to be expected when we put in Storm Chaser. And this year, we're up over last year. Not 41%, but we're up, which is pretty good considering that we're going up against the Storm Chaser. So the word continues to spread about the king, its quality, its good pricing, and we appreciate you all spread that word as well, so maybe more people have an opportunity to ride from the run as well. Yes, young man.
So I've ridden Thunder Run and Beast, and I think both the Beast and Thunder Run, they're rough, but the Beast does it hurt. Thunder Run does hurt.
Okay,
oh, come
what
on.
What is it about Thunder Run? What do you get hurt on Thunder Run?
On some of the turns after the first fair tunnels.
Yeah, that's exactly the area we worked this for. We spent $250 million and we worked the area. Good observation.
Awesome.
Have you ridden Holly World Ride, my ultimate defense?
I was there yesterday.
What do you say?
It did hurt, but boy, it was good.
Goes what?
It did hurt, but it was also pretty good.
Okay. Thank you for your honesty. We appreciate it. That's what we're about. Let's tell it right here. Any other questions, Gary?
I'd like to suggest to the gentleman to just quote, the next time you're at King's Island, ride the back seat of the beast.
Okay.
It will hurt.
If we had to put a Halloween program, we might have to raise the price of our season pass. I'd rather give them a value in the counter of the season than come with a tangential shoulder season event. So that's an economic decision right or wrong. You know, we can consider it Sunday right now with no intention to go to Halloween. We do have intention, though, of celebrating our 30th anniversary, which is in 2019. Our 30th anniversary. It takes about 2 to 3 years to actually design, work out, locate the right next major attraction. So we're in the thick of that right now, and even Mark Brewer doesn't know where that attraction will be. And he works it all the time. But we have something special planned for 2019, so stay tuned. Yes, sir.
Going back to
step closer to the microphone.
Thunder runs smooth, but and the beast is jerky. But the beast is longer and higher. I understand you can't build that high. But that's one reason why the beast is better than Thunder Run.
You know what's interesting about that, and I appreciate it. And listen, every experience on the roller coaster is very personal and subjective, right? Or somebody likes it and doesn't like it. But about height, I've heard a lot about height when it comes to roller coasters. The tallest are not always the best. Take a look at Storm Chaser. Right? Last year, Storm Chaser was voted the number 2 best new ride in the world. And Storm Chaser was, what, 120 feet tall. One of the things that lowering the height of a coaster, again, you probably know a lot more about this than I do, but lowering the height of a roller coaster allows you to react more quickly when you come down the drop. When you have a big drop, it takes a while to dissipate the energy, so you can't do a lot of quick motions right after the big drop. So the big drop is always extremely exhilarating and a lot of fun, but oftentimes it's a one-trick pony. When you come to a ride like Storm Chaser or Lightning Run, you can do a lot more twisted turns right away, which creates another form of excitement. So pick your poison. Big drop, excitement. A lot of action, also exciting. It's a very professional thing. But I appreciate your effort. Thank you. One more question at this one. No, you already spoke. You can't. I'm sorry. Don't like that. Go to the microphone.
Two words.
Go to the microphone.
Go to the mic, yeah.
You already spoke. No, you didn't spike in the microphone. We have very strict rules here.
Night time, rise.
Say again.
Nighttime rise.
So, nighttime rise. then okay. So that means I gotta spend what, maybe $2 or $3 million to light up the park at night. No need the lights really. Tell our security force. Remember, okay, inside, we love the fact that we're an urban park. We take that very seriously. We're an urban park. We employ white, black, brown, red team members from all over the community, all sections of the community, upper class, lower class, middle class. We're an urban park to serve everybody. With that comes certain challenges, because you're an urban park. Okay? We take those challenges very seriously. I think we'll agree, at least anybody who has a season pass that comes here frequently, we want a safe and a very clean park. It's not that easy. It's behind the scenes, believe me, our managers and directors work so hard to deliver that experience for you all. It's not, when it feels easy, we're doing a good job, but it's not easy. A lot of work and training that goes into it, just like it's a lot of work and training going to put the service department or our operators or lifeguards or what have you. But we're an urban park. Can you name one other urban park in America? I'm only aware of one. Village Gardens in Denver. Every other park is on the outskirts of a metropolitan area that you generally have to drive through. It could be 20, 25, 30 minutes. Kings Island's in Mason. You can't just hop on a bus and go to that park like you can here in the metropolitan system. You gotta get into a car, you gotta get into your RV, whatever. We have a totally different challenge that we love and we absorb. We love our team members, we love the fact that we employ 1,400 young people that work in this facility. So we're an urban park and we're proud of it. When you go to some of the other parks, look around. Just look around. And you see, we're not like Kentucky Timber. The nature of people they employ, the nature of the quality of guests and all that stuff. So we're very proud of being one of America's few urban parks that can still deliver that same smile and that wonderful and safe atmosphere. You've heard me say this before. It's all about one thing. Make mom happy. Make mom happy. Sorry guys, make mom happy. We try to do that. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Thank you for talking.